Hey guys, SanctusFides here, and I'm playing some Bioshock Remastered. As I've said before, just in my previous video log, is that this is one of my favorite games of all time, so I'm really excited to play the remastered version. I haven't played it since the first one came out on the 360, but unfortunately it was such a memorable experience to me that I still have quite a bit of memory to it, so it won't be as fresh as it is for you if this is your first time watching it, but I will go through some good steps to try not have anything spoiled for you. Now, I have already played about 30 to 40 minutes of this game, and I did record it, but unfortunately, the new update to my recording software broke that video pretty badly. I found out way too late that it pretty much halves the frames in it. And I also saw that someone else had the same issue, so once I installed the previous version, the stable build, it worked like a charm. So I'm going to go ahead and re-record that. Unfortunately, that means you're not going to see me reacting to stuff for the first time. It's going to be like, ah, yes, this again, because, as I said before, I've played this game before, so. I'm going to go ahead and, I would crank it down to about this, which is the pretty much the proper level it should be, but I know YouTube can be a little weird with blacks, like the crushed black look that shadows have in games. So I'm going to leave it just a little tinge higher, so this should be good. Now, I'm going to play it on hard, not survivor, not medium either, because medium just could be too easy. Hard's a pretty good middle ground. It's a little harder at the beginning because you start out with no powers and any of that stuff, so we're going to do hard and not survivor, because if I do survivor, all you're going to do is see me die a whole bunch, and what the hell, you don't want to watch that, do you? I wouldn't want to watch it. So, we're going to go ahead and do this. So, I'm going to get to the same place I left off last time, probably a little faster, because I had to go through and get a lot of settings also set up. Audio was had to change some settings, had to change some controls. So, now that the start of the game's coming up, I'm going to go ahead and shut my mouth for this.
They told me, son, you're special. You were born to do great things. You know what?
They lied. Right. And that sound you heard is people dying in a plane wreck. What a fantastic way to start the game. Now, I'm going to have to see if the audio dialogue is stayed. I don't know if my settings were just for that one save, but they shouldn't be. But I saw no text for the opening sequence. Because for you guys out there, I have the subtitles put on so you can read. Ah, yes, my handbag and my locket. What will I do without them? Ooh, was that a propeller? There goes the fuselage. I'm guessing there's about 20 people trapped in that. And shabammy. And this is a pretty great set of visuals here. By modern standards, it's a little, old, but it's just a remastered version. But back in the day, when I first saw this, I literally stood here for about 30 seconds thinking that the game hadn't started yet. And I was like, oh, shit. You can just start moving. Thought that was a really amazing... Oh, Jesus. Thought that was a really amazing touch that they did. And I'm really glad you can't dive underwater and watch that thing sink down to the bottom, because that would scare the shit out of me. As y'all know, I'm a... Wow. Oh, that is weird. That is a weird bug. Changing the volume with my volume knob on my keyboard pauses the game. What the hell? Like I was trying to say, you know that anytime I have to go underwater in a game, I become a scared little baby because there's just something about it that freaks me out. I don't know why. Deep bodies of water freak me out. It's like transisomethanphobia. There's an actual word for being scared of large bodies of water, and here we are. We crash very conveniently next to... Damn, that moon looks nice. We crash very conveniently next to a lighthouse in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. With a immaculate gold door, which would be... You could retire on selling that shit right there. Straight up. Straight up. That would be amazing. Alright. This feels safe.
No gods or kings, only man.
with a giant head. Or a giant bust, I should say. What's it say underneath it? I never read that before. The Great Chain? Is that what that says? Yeah, the Great Chain. The Great Chain of what? Like a rapper's chain? Can I get an answer to what that chain is? The chain is of, I guess, science. Industry! Arts! And... R. I guess that's not part of it. Alright, so... this is a pretty neat looking little submarine. I don't know if that's supposed to look like a little animal's head, but it kind of does. It's like a nice welcoming animal, welcoming me to a nice hug. Okay, pick that up. And down we go! This part was so awesome the first time I played this game. It was like an amusement ride to me. 10 fathoms! And a naked person. 18 fathoms. Ooh, movie time. Fire at your fingertips. Incinerate. Plasmids by Andrew Ryan. Ryan.
And I'm here to ask you a question. Is a man not entitled to the sweat of his brow? No. Says the man in Washington, it belongs to the poor.
It's a big-ass eagle.
No, says the man in the Vatican, it belongs to God. No, says the man in Moscow, it belongs to everyone. I rejected those answers. Instead, I chose something different. I chose the impossible. I chose rapture. The artist would not fear the censor, where the scientist would not be bound by petty morality, where the great would not be constrained by the small. And with the sweat of your brow, rapture can become your city as well.
I'm not gonna lie, that sounds like a pretty great city, especially the upcoming elections. I wouldn't mind going to a place that respects those kind of things, that's for sure. And hello, big metal man, and hello, big whale. I would be scared shitless if I looked out a window and saw a giant blue whale. I mean, Jesus. All it has to do is ram into the building, and then what? I like how you overhear people talking about you arriving and that someone needs to come get you before the splicers get you. How ominous is that? Let's see if Johnny comes to greet us. Sorry for the loading screen. It happens a few times in this, and it's saving. Johnny. Johnny, don't look so hot in this situation. Oh! Death gurgle. Apparently he was killed by a double pirate. Look at them hooks. Hey lady, if ya... leave me alone, I'll be your friend. I'm okay with pirate hook hands. I got no quarrel with that. You got no beef with me, I got no beef with you. Please leave my protective shell alone. Oh god, lady. Get off! She's doing a lot of damage for two hooks. How are you talking to me through that? No.
I don't know how you survived that plane crash, but I've never been one to question Providence. I'm Atlas, and I aim to keep you alive. Now keep on moving. We're gonna have to get you to higher ground.
Higher ground sounds good, considering I'm incredibly low in the ocean.
Take a deep breath and step out of the bathysphere. I won't leave you twisting in the wind. We're gonna need to draw her out of hiding, but you're gonna have to trust me.
That actually, I never noticed those shutters going down. That's an excellent way to darken the environment without having some bullshit. So that when you do step out, the world kind of opens up more. That's really nice. That's a very good little quick detail. What do they say? Let it end. Let us ascend. Okay. Ryan doesn't own us. I assume some people weren't so thrilled with being kept down here. But I assume Mr. Andrew Ryan, the creator of this world, would not want people knowing about his cool little ocean society. I can imagine that the government have the issue with that, you know? The world would probably be very cruel to this idea. Okay.
Just a bit further. How do you like that, sister?
Oh, sorry, I was looking up at the sign. So she's gone.
Now, would you kindly find a crowbar or something?
Where's that robot go?
Bloody splicer, seal Johnny M.
This robot, where you into?
Oh,
okay.
Splicers.
All right. We got us a wrench. We got us a wrench. Okay. In we go. Okay. Flaming sofa. Jeez. Okay. How do I get over this without getting burned? Okay. Cool. I just don't get burned. All right.
I found her that way.
All right. You have to die. Nope, nope, nope. Alright, so that's the combat with the wrench. It is my favorite weapon in this game. I enjoy it quite a bit. And also, as you notice, what can I do? I can search bins and containers and get new stuff, which, as you all know, is one of my favorite things to do in a game. Just search the room, find all the stuff, collect it all, and be kick ass. So. Ooh, pep bar, potato chips. Can I go up this way? Nope, game does not want me to go that way. Ooh, hello, trash can. Bam! This game is pretty gratuitous with the blood, and I like that. Open plasmids. Okay. Little lonely TV over here. Detail. Okay, light 'em up, security bullseye. What's this one say? Get there and hurry! Teleportation. Plasmids by Andrew Ryan. There's just something about this era that makes me love talking that way. Doggy. Alright. So, boys and girls, you know what you do whenever you find a strange vial with a syringe attached to it? That's right, boys and girls. You just pick it up and you jam it right there into your vein. Just go ahead. Right there. And once it's in there, go ahead and just inject it fearlessly. Just go ahead. That's the rational thing you'd like to do.
Steady now. Your genetic code is being rewritten.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on and everything will be fine.
Because that's what logic dictates. Just shove it right in your vein.
This little fish looks like he just had his cherry popped. Wonder if he's still got some atom on him. Yeah. Let's bark. Weak! You're a weak chopper.
What's a chopper? A weak chopper?
Yellow always had been. You'll be no better off with Metal Daddy, little fish. See you floating, the briny.
And the briny? Oh boy, they're using some old school words. Not even I'm familiar with them. That's a big ass drill. And that's a little creepy girl.
Look, Mr. Bubbles, it's an angel. I can see light coming from his belly. Wait a minute, he's still breathing. It's all right. I know he'll be an angel soon.
Hmm. I don't know how comfortable I'd be if I woke up to a little girl with glowy eyes telling me I'm gonna be an angel soon. I think I'd scramble for a gun.
First time plasma, a real kick from a mule. But there's nothing like a fistful of lightning now, is there?
Boop, boop. Alright, so back to the whole jammy shit in your vein thing. Why not test it out on the dead body? Like, first? Oh, I like this. Pick your plasma, and then it shows that a person's zapping the light to make the electricity work. Even if, you know, you couldn't figure it out yourself to do that, I like that in the environment, there's some giant indicator telling you what to do. Very subtly. Oh, okay, now it just tells you pretty obviously tells you what to do there. But let's go ahead and pretend it didn't do that, and they were just trying to guide you through. Oh, shit, fuselage. Natural means. Alright, time to go on this wild ride. Actually, I'm not going that fast. This is, let's go on a tame ride. Alright. Alrighty. Whew. As soon as I get the shivers, as if I actually just came out of a cold water area into the cool, brisk wind for air. Alright, potato chips. Don't need them yet. What I do need is some hypo. Hypo, or Eve hypo, what Eve is in this game is your mana. And a first aid is your to replenish your health. If you drink alcohol in this, you gain health, but you're...
Splicer! Give him the combo. Zap him, then whack him. 1-2 punch.
I'll tell you later.
The 1-2 punch!
Where did he go?
All I want to do is
beat
someone.
Bam! Bam! Hey, 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 hey! Get the fuck back here!
Fresh hair, then save up.
So like I tried saying, Eve is basically your mana in this game. If you use your plasmids, as you saw me do there, you pull out the blue vial and you shove it right in your arm. Then you can do more. And I found this last time. It's a fucking dead cat. It's not like a prop cat because you know why? You know how I know? Fucking smack on the head. Blood. Blood everywhere. There's more blood that shoots out of the cat than there's inside of the cat. Okay. Storage. Jeez, I've gotten 5 Eve hypos already. Can also break the alcohol, so if you ever need it, don't do that, because you won't have it. Alright, what was over here? Alright, so potato chips, they're not like bandages, where in the top left corners you see where it's like +4, it means I can use 4 things to heal myself up. These are instant activated. Cigarettes will give you more Eve, but they lower your health, so it's kind of a neat way to try to survive, because this is kind of like a survival game. So... If you need one, you can trade a little more of the other. Go ahead. Well, someone was begging for their life. It didn't seem like it worked out too well.
I can control myself. I can.
What? Jesus, you gotta be real fucked up to not feel fire. It's like PCP level shit. Alright, give me that juice box.
Ooh, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. I like that juice box.
Pardon us, or pardon our dust. Elevator, Celsior, repair. I love all the little branding details in this. It's such fantastic stuff. Cause I'm a huge fan of like the older 40s and 30s eras aesthetics, and this is like right up my alley.
Listen, I've got a family. I need to get them out of here, but the splicers have cut me off from them. If you can reach them in Neptune's bounty, then maybe, just maybe. I know you must feel like the unluckiest man in the world right now, but you're the only hope I'll ever see my wife and child again. Go to Neptune's bounty. Find my family, please.
Aww. Oh, I detect shiny. That's another good thing about this, is the shinies. That lady's fucking crazy.
Mom's gone. What do I do? Wait. This is happening before? At none? Why aren't you here? Why is it today and not then when you were warm and sweet? Can't Mommy hold you to her breast and feel your teeth? Oh, no. No, no, no. Baby, amazing!
Lady, you're fucking crazy and you have to die. What's she talking about? Why can't I hold you to my breast and you feel your teeth?
Oh, my teeth? They destroyed our bodies, our minds. We couldn't handle it. Best friends butchering one another. Babies strangled in cribs. The whole city went to hell.
Yep, so that's splicers. People use too many plasmids and go horribly genetic all fucked up. So. Ooh, hello, Rapture Masquerade Ball 1959. What? Whoa, I forgot it's 59 in this? The style straight out of the 30s, man. Wow, how long have they been down here for? This guy's a little crazy. Wow, put those shots right into her face. Oh shit. Okay, someone out there is a little unhinged as well. Okay, let's see what we got here. We got some dollars, some more dollars, and we got some bullets and some dollars. And some radioactive waste in the refrigerator, it seems. Okay. Got some more dollars. Don't need any alcohol. Anything back there? Nope, nope, nope. Okay. Well.
If you spot a splicer in the water, hit him with the electrical.
I win, GG. You're all stupid. Okay. Whoa, my hand is flickering. What the heck? Because of that? Yes, it was. That's a weird effect. Whoa, that's a weird effect. Okay. Hello. Whoa, look at their faces. Their face went away. What the fuck? Wow, that's some crazy water effects. Boy, they do not look so great. Alright, so here's the way that the game tells you the backstory of this place and what it was like before everything went to shit. And it's through these little audio diaries, so let's go ahead and give it a listen to.
Another New Year's, another night alone. I'm out and you're stuck in Hephaestus, working. Imagine.
Hold on, I do need to go in and change one more audio thing. We're gonna bring these down a bit to about there. I thought I did them one more. Did the audio not save? Oh, shoot. I thought I brought him down earlier, and I did, but it seems that I forgot to hit apply.
Surprise. Well, I guess I'll have another drink. Here's a toast to Diane McClintock. Silliest girl in Rapture. Silly enough to fall in love with Andrew Ryan. Silly enough.
Okay, so it seems that there was a party here for New Year's Eve, which is when all this shit went down. Wow, look at that pop-in effect. Whoa, that's really bad. Holy shit. There's not even a setting I can pick to make it stop. Watch, I'll show you. Graphics options. Yeah, see? There's literally, like, nothing I can do. Can't do anything about that. These are the settings, folks. Oh, wait, what? Why is that all the way down? There we go. That saved, right? One more check. Yes, it did. Okay. Yeah, still, it doesn't do anything. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, sorry. So, yeah, so there was this New Year's Eve party, and people in Discord won't stop messaging me. Holy shit, I forgot about you. Oh, God. Okay. So, yeah, it seemed like this party was going on, and... for New Year's Eve, and that, for some reason, a group of people came in, so were saying, you know, down with Andrew Ryan, long live, like, Atlas or something, and Atlas is the guy who I'm supposed to be helping. So, he seems to have been leading some kind of rebellion. I didn't notice that the first time I listened to that audio tape. Isn't that interesting? Yeah, you're probably hideous.
Hey, Brenda, you care to tell me why you've had a hole in the wall the size of Plymouth Rock coming out of your crapper going on 3 weeks now? Now, I ain't saying I'm Shakespeare, I'm trying to run a respectable theater. I got working folk coming in from Corey Neptune trying to catch a little diversion. And all I can think about is the stink coming out of your
He just popped out and got shot in the head. Love it. Alright, so look at this gigantic hole in the restroom. Okay, so my sensitivity is about to go absolutely bonkers. It did this the first time it came through here, and it just goes absolutely batshit, see?
Careful now. Would you kindly lower that weapon for a minute? You think that's a child down there? Don't be fooled. She's a little sister now. Somebody went and turned a sweet baby girl into a monster. Whatever you thought about right and wrong on the surface, well, that don't count for much down in Rapture. Those little sisters,
they carry Adam.
The genetic material that keeps the wheels of Rapture turning. Everybody wants it, everybody needs it.
Why doesn't he just straight up shoot the little girl? He's got a gun. Well. Said he'll punch a little girl in the face. Up. There's her buddy. Mr. Red Eyes pissed off drill man. Oh, so brutal. Oh jeez.
That's the big daddy. She got it out of.
Yep, I got no desire to ever fuck with that guy. So yeah, I'm not actually sure why my sensitivity goes absolutely batshit bonkers there. It just does. It's pretty weird. Pretty weird bug, but hopefully that's the only time, because it's very hard to control. I have to, like, just barely move the mouse. And here we are on our stage, and a one, and a two, and let's go. Okay, so we're at our second Vita Chamber. Haven't died yet, haven't had to respawn. We're doing some pretty good stuff right here. We got 9 of these. Is what mode did I put this on? Gameplay options. Is there a difficulty? Yeah, it's on hard.
Okay.
All right, so let's just keep rolling. I had to just check it. Seemed a little easy.
So stuck up.
Okay. She didn't see me, so I shot her. Seemed reasonable. Oh, was she gonna try to look in there?
Did they see that?
Oh,
I just wanted some company.
You just wanted some company? Let's just talk then. Let's talk. Or not. Bash your face in. That works too. Hello, trash can. Nothing. Okay. Alright, so there's more of these weird fucks. Oh, hello. Y'all are in water. Thank you. Whoop, don't step in that too early, John. How'd they kill- Oh, Jesus, how'd they kill a Big Daddy? There we go. Alright, give me all money. Nothing. Hello, Big Daddy. Ooh, don't mind if I do, $33! That's the biggest score I've gotten yet so far. You're not so tough now, are you, big boy? Okay, whoop, let that effect end. Alright. Here we are. Medical Pavilion and Neptune's Bounty. But first, explore. Okay. Oh, hello, restroom. Okay, last time I went in a restroom, I got jumped. This game is so much like real life. Sorry. No, I don't get jumped when I go to a restroom. I live in Houston. We're not freaking Detroit.
Ooh, hello.
Oh, crap, I'm full. I have 9. Okay, well, hey, that's good. Forgot you max out at 9. Let's go over here. Hello, storage crates. Oh, shit. Made myself drunk. Well, damn. Shouldn't have done that. I fell for that last time, too. Hello, trash can. Alright, on to Neptune's. Ah, ha, 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 ha. Not so fast, the game says. It belongs to the people. Oh, sorry. It's like the beginning movie. Okay. Come on. Oh, shit. That's a flamethrower. Woo. Stay away from the. Oh, hello. Yes, jump in the water. That's a good idea. Okay, you don't run at me. This is easy so far. That arm just amazing at video games. Maybe we can turn it up to Survivor. I don't know.
I don't know yet. I don't know.
Come on down. Win a prize. Jump in the water. You win a prize. Yo, what's your prize? It's eternal death. You too? You want some of that? Yeah, you want some of that. All right. What am I waiting for? I'm grabbing all this shit from these bodies, dude. This is some great pillaging. I should just sit by water and kill people more often. Okay, so I got the money finally. Okay. All right, all right. We'll run. Doop, 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 doop. Doop, 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 doop. Oh, I hate the water effect. Make a run for it. Ah, damn.
So tell me, friend, which one of the bitches sent you? The KGB wolf or the CIA jackal? Here's the news. Rapture isn't some sunken ship for you to plunder. And Anvil Ryan isn't a giddy socialite who can be slapped around by government muscle. And with that, farewell. Or das Vidania, whichever you will.
Das Vidania. Das Vidania. I swear I've heard, okay. Heard that in Overwatch. Oh shit, hello, I can just shoot you on the head. Cool. Can I loot your buddy? No, I can't. Okay. Am I gonna have to fight them? Alright, I'm getting out. Alright, go, go, go. Ha, I never even knew I could shoot him. Okay. So we're almost done with this video. Gonna leave it off where I left off in the last time because I think it's an excellent chapter to end on. Also, I know my videos start pushing an hour long in length, and I don't mean to do that. I'm gonna actually revise how I do my Witcher 3 videos. I just heard a witch cackle. I heard you heard it, right?
Now you've met Andrew Ryan, the bloody king of Rapture. Now find your way to emergency access.
With Adam, there's no reason to not to be beautiful. Dr. Steinman's cosmetic enhancement.
Okay, sorry. Tried starting that. But water went down the wrong pipe. I tried speaking through it. Didn't work. Hope that doesn't give me the hiccups. Okay, I hear that bitch. Where is she? Ooh, vending machine.
The Circus of Values!
See, that's where I got that from. Fun fact, that's actually like the director of the game. He did that voice himself. Okay, so this is where you can either search this or you can hack it. Now, hacking it, you think, how can you hack in like 1959 when everything is still based off the 30s? Well, I'll tell you, it's magic. As you can see, it's pretty nonsensical, actually. I don't freaking know how this is hacking, but apparently you just, you know, you just let the water go through and you hacked it. You made the water go through the thing and you hacked it. I don't really know how that works, but either way, I get a little security bot and look, he's green. And what does that mean? It means he follows me around and shoots at people for me. I'll let them fight. It's easier this way. Wow. They really had a fight up there. Holy crap, I've never just watched them. I've always intervened. This is a whole thing.
That won't work for long.
You're infecting this whole flight.
I'm your better.
Holy shit. Wow, that was really crazy. You did pretty well. Hey. How did I miss that shot, by the way? I thought I was totally going to have that, but apparently not. Okay. You know what? Let's just use the hell thing so I can pick one up. Actually, I need to stop doing that because I might actually switch the difficulty up a bit to the max. And you actually need, like, all the stuff you can get. And plus, there's bandages right here. Damn. Could just use that. All right.
Ryan and Adam. Adam and Ryan. All those years of study. And was I ever truly a surgeon before I met them? How we clinked away with our scalpels and toy morality. Yes, we could lop a boil here and shave down a beak there, but... but could we really change anything? No. But Adam gives us the means to do it. And Ryan frees us from the phony ethics that held us back. Change your look, change your sex, change your race. It's yours to change. Nobody else's.
Ah, so that's kind of like where... that's how they're telling the backstory. That's the introduction to Dr. Steinman. And it's actually not a bad pursuit. It's kind of noble, you know. Be free to change anything you want. We have the means, why not? Hello, pistol rounds. Ooh, hello, pistol. So, that's pretty cool. Let's go on up here. What does this do? Emergency access control. Oh, yeah, because they took over and they locked everything down. I say fuck that, bitches.
Don't you!
Don't you what?
You want to use the emergency access, you'll be needing Dr. Steinman's key.
Oh, yeah. Ah, okay. So again, we are going to turn this stuff down even more. Because I can't get the voiceover any higher than it is. It sounds so quiet, and I'm really afraid that when I... because I lower the audio when I make my videos. I lower the audio to keep my microphone just a tinge higher. And I'm worried that it's just going to be too quiet. So thank God I have the audio, the dialogue subtitles. So let's go ahead and get us a fucking Tommy gun. Oh, yeah. Up. Okay. It really is. You rattle the monkey cage. It really is like that. Okay. Machine gun's awesome. Just, come on, one at a time. Let's go. And you. Okay. Next, please. Come on. Next. Ow. My own freaking... quadcopter is hurting me. Little bastard. Aha! Oh, don't want to shoot him. Whoa! Got pretty low on health there. Okay, you know what? I can just smack the crap out of you. Stop hurting me!
Jesus, you're supposed to be on my side!
Whew. Alright, let's go back and start looting all these. I do like, I do like the varied costume on the splicers, but then I'm like, oh, it's the same. It's just a recolor. Okay, you, I already searched you, okay. Well, let's see here. Everything looks about correct. And I'm actually going to leave all the stuff here because this is where I'm going to decide we leave off at. Ooh, the pistol. I forgot the pistols fall out of their hands. So her pistol is here. Uh-huh. I gotta look extra careful for that kind of stuff. Alright, like I said, this is a good place to leave off at. It's the whole next chapter is going to be exploring and doing what we need to in the medical pavilion. So, oh wow, my field of view is a little high. Hmm, it is. Because look at the... Whoa, elongation of the sign up there. Okay, let's turn that down. Let's just turn it down a little bit. Let's put it back to 100. That's what it came at, so. This is good. This looks about right. I can deal with this. I'll turn it up if I need to. But like I said, I'm going to go ahead and leave it off here. This is where we left off in the last one. You know, it still took me about the same exact amount of time to get here, so I'm not too sure why. I mean, I do sit through the things, and I do listen to them at the same time, so that's that. I will be trying to make these videos shorter if I can. I will be doing the Witcher one shorter. I'll be doing Fallout 4 as well coming up, and I'm only going to do one or two quests at a time with that, so I'm not going to be overburdening you, and it's not going to be like the quest where, you know, do... What are those guys? The Frontier guys that you run? I'm not going to do those bullshit quests where they just send you out to go help a person and they send you on this quest 100 different times. It's going to be only the unique fetch. Go into this place, get this thing, do that thing. It's going to be the special quests. So, if you want to check those out, go ahead. They're going to be up on my channel. I'm going to be trying to get a video of that soon. And not to mention, I have a new series coming up very soon. It's going to be the Mafia 2 game. It's a game that I have not played through yet. So, just like how this is not a new experience for me, but it might be for you, next game will be a new experience for you and myself as well. So, we'll be in for some surprises and some good fun. So, this is SanctusFides, signing out.